What's up, everyone? We're back here with a really cool vendor. Well, not a vendor. I shouldn't say a vendor, but a filmmaker. Is that correct?
That's right, yeah.
What's your name, bud?
My name is Richard Birkin. I am the writer, director, and executive producer of the new feature film, Fang. It's going to be coming out next year.
So a new movie called Fang, and I see you have books here. You want to show the crowd what we have here?
Yeah, this is the official booklet for Fang. I'm giving these booklets out for free, so everybody who walks by here sees this booklet, they think it looks interesting, they'll get a chance to look at it and see, you know, and this booklet shows you pictures from the movie. It gives you a lot of good information, and that will, I hope, you know, if you get one of these booklets, then the movie will stick in your mind more, and you're going to remember when you see this come up on streaming, on DVD, in theaters, you're going to be like, hey, I remember this, you know, I got the Fang booklet, so you'll have that memory, you'll have that personal connection.
Nice. So what's the movie, real quick, Rick, what's the movie about? I mean, just without any spoilers, what is it about?
Well, Fang is the story of a young man named Billy Cochran. He's a janitor. He lives with his mother in this gritty neighborhood on the south side of Chicago. Okay. And Billy has undiagnosed autism, so he's very isolated. He's very disconnected from the people around him. He doesn't go to a lot of parties, I'll put it like that. So one night, Billy wakes up, he has to use the bathroom at home, and there's this rat in the bathtub. So the rat jumps out of the bathtub, it chases him around the living room of his house, and then the rat bites him. And so from that point forward, Billy starts to feel like he's turning into a rat. He sees this rat fur on his arms, and he feels more and more like a rat. And I can't say too much more than that without giving it away.
Don't spoil it. Oh,
yeah, so it's about the transformation from man into rat.
Oh, that's pretty cool, man. Pretty cool movie here. How long did it take you to do, or you directed all this too?
Oh, yeah. Well, we filmed over a period of 23 days in January and February 2020. We were incredibly lucky with the timing. It was right before the pandemic started. Is when we filmed this. We were incredibly, incredibly lucky.
That's amazing. So definitely, you know, it's, and also I heard that this is your first time here, right? Days of the Dead?
Oh, yeah.
How do you like it so far, bud?
Well, I'm getting to meet some really cool people such as yourself, and I'm getting to spread the word about Fang. These are some amazing different stands and vendors we have here. It's a great time.
Absolutely. So where can our viewers reach out, or at least reach out to you? Or do you have a website or social media out there?
Well, the official social media for Fang is the Fang Facebook page. And we have the link to that on the back of these booklets. And then the listing Fang's IMDb page is here in the booklet. So those are the two links to Fang's online presence.
I gotta say, I'm really impressed with this book because it's so detailed, high quality too, and a lot of behind the scenes of what this film could be leading up to. So definitely, it's a well-made book.
Oh, thank you.
Awesome book, awesome job, by the way. And definitely, folks, check it out, Fang, which is supposed to be coming out very soon. Support him. Support his social media, and like I said, with Tribe 3 Productions, we love to support independent filmmakers, and this is definitely one for Richard that you definitely want to look up after for movie Fang. So any last final shout outs or words you want to say to our viewers out there?
Well, I hope everybody who's watching this gets a chance to watch Fang after the movie comes out, and I hope you have a fantastic time watching it.
Well, it's a pleasure to meet you, Richard. Thanks for having us
today. Adrian, thank you.
Thank you for your time. And folks, again, scope out the social media. Stay tuned for more at Tribe 3 Productions. We got plenty of more vendors, and we have a special segment coming up soon. Check it out. All right, folks, we're back here at Days of the Dead, and this is one vendor that I've been always trying to feature, and finally, we got a chance to get to you today.
Very good, sir.
So, as we pass by, you always have this awesome space music sign. It's always flashing out.
Yeah.
So tell us more. First of all, what's your name?
My name is Dave Kaufman.
Okay. So tell me, Dave, what do you have here to offer for the public here?
Music that might make you feel as though you're in outer space.
Oh, really? Okay.
That's why I refer to it as space music.
Space music. All right. So tell me, what's your latest CDs that you have here today?
Well, it's been a while since I've actually released something on my own label. What we're playing now is a re-release of something that I had released some years earlier. It's probably the most recent thing that I've arranged to get pressed, or in this case, repressed.
How long have you been doing this for?
I've been doing this for almost 30 years, I'd say.
Oh, okay.
Yes, it's been kind of plodding along.
And I see that you've been active here with Days of the Dead. You're a regular, right? A regular vendor?
That is correct. I've been doing this for about 6, maybe 7 years.
That's awesome.
That is for this particular convention.
Okay.
I've also done a couple of Days of the Deads in Indianapolis.
Oh, you have? Okay.
Yes.
How's it over there?
It's pretty similar to this. Maybe not quite as large as this, but I've only done that convention a couple of years. And the 2021 was, the one in 2020, I should say, was really small.
Oh, was it? Okay.
I think it was more a case of they wanted to show that they could do it in the wake of the government's response to the health epidemic.
Oh, yeah. The epidemic really, really messed things up. But you know what? It's you make it feel better when you listen to some space music, right?
That is certainly true.
So what's your latest three CDs you have here, your latest work, your latest ones?
Okay, I would say that there's this one over here,
okay,
which is by a Belgian synthesist.
All right.
And let's see, there's this one over here, which is by the late Conrad Schnitzler.
Right.
There are also a couple of re-releases over here that were originally on the Hearts of Space label, this one and that one.
Right.
And band in question, which is a French duo called Lightwave, authorized us to re-release those back in 2005, 2006, and so I did.
All right. So when it came down to your music, so what sparked the idea of doing this type of music? You just woke up one day, or just your imagination, or that you had the music in your mind, or what got you into the space music here?
What got me into trying to market and sell the music,
okay,
was that back in the early 1990s, I was involved with a magazine that focused on the musical activities of the German electronic rock group Tangerine Dream, as well as the various musicians who had been in that band at one time or another. Well, one of those musicians, British synthesist Steve Jolliffe, whose CDs I have on display here, asked us to help distribute some of his releases. We did. Then he asked us to release his newer material. We did that. In time, that grew to be more lucrative than publishing the magazine, which was a very, very time-consuming and very costly endeavor. Eventually, I wound up scrapping the magazine and just focusing on distributing CDs.
I got you. So, what are your future plans with the music now? You've been doing it, you say, for 30 years now. Where do you see yourself in the next 10 years from now?
Pretty much doing what I'm doing now, because, as I said, I'm just plodding along with this sort of thing.
Okay.
It's a real niche market. As a result, the sales are not enough for me to do this full time. I do this in addition to my day job.
Okay, so pretty much what almost some of these vendors are doing too, on their day job too, and they have their side gig on the side too, right?
I guess so.
So for our viewers, where can they experience and or purchase or listen to these CDs at on your social media?
I'm not on social media per se. I do have a website called hmnetwork.com. That's H as in Horizon, M as in Music, Network, that's all one word, .com. We've got MP3 samples of our releases for listening to, and people can also order CDs that way.
There you go, folks. You just made it more easy to purchase this awesome music. Make sure you go to the website, support the music. The space music is pretty much something that's very unique that we should listen to, and it's very unique also. Wouldn't you agree?
Yes, I would. Well, definitely.
Definitely check them out. Thank you so much for your time. We'll hope to see you again, of course, in the next Days of the Dead. And ladies and gentlemen, we got more vendors coming down in our next video, so stay tuned. And don't forget, space music is the way to go. Take a chance on it and listen to it.
Thank you for having me on.
This is Triad 3 Productions. We'll talk to you, and we'll see you in a bit. Okay. Stay tuned.